Right, friends, welcome back to Questions and Answers for 52nd week. Mazuli, the largest river island, will become the country's first ever carbon neutral district by 2020. And two, three aspects I would like to tell you. Mazuli was created as a district. It is represented by Assam Chief Minister. It is the largest river island. Then another important aspect is this will become carbon neutral district by 2020, country's first ever carbon neutral district. What is the meaning of carbon neutral district? Carbon neutral district means carbon emissions will be totally absorbed with green cover. The emissions of carbons will be totally absorbed. So the net carbon emissions after absorption will be zero. So that is the meaning of this carbon neutral. All of you are hearing about two airports. One is the Delhi airport as well as Rajiv Gandhi International Airport at Shamshabad, Hyderabad. So these two were declared as carbon free. That means the emissions are totally absorbed. That is, name the country which got maximum number of World Heritage Sites. World Heritage Sites are declared by UNESCO, that is one part. And the second important aspect is Italy has got maximum 50 World Heritage Sites, and this is as per the UNESCO report. Then Rio de Janeiro was accorded World Heritage status recently, and more than this, I would like to tell you, two important sites were destroyed recently, World Heritage Sites, Palmyra as well as Aleppo. These two are in Syria, these things don't forget. Italy is the country in the heart of Mediterranean Sea. Then next one is FCRA licenses of Greenpeace India and two NGOs were cancelled. FCRA means Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. This act belongs to 2010, and here the funding to non-governmental organizations from foreign land are regulated. That is the main purpose of Foreign Contribution Regulation Act. Initially, it was brought in 1976 at the time of emergency, subsequently modified in 2010, and the nodal ministry for implementation of Foreign Contribution Regulation Act is the Ministry of Home Affairs, don't forget. Name the airport which became the second in Asia Pacific region to achieve carbon neutral status. This is Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad, and previously Delhi Airport, that is Indira Gandhi International Airport in Delhi, was declared as carbon neutral. Here carbon neutral means, as I have already explained, total carbon emissions released are totally absorbed. Who among the following Indian American CEO joined as US President elect's 19-member strategic and policy forum? Indira Nooyi, CEO of PepsiCo, will be one of the members of 19-member strategic and policy forum. And here, the other two members I have listed here. There are total 19. Out of 19 members, I listed three here. Indira Nooyi, PepsiCo CEO. And if someone talks you about CEO of Uber, most of you are using the taxis of Uber, and the CEO is Travis Kalanick, and Elon Musk is famous for his Tesla Motors. Tesla Motors is behind the development of electric vehicles. And then SpaceX. SpaceX is in the process of developing reusable rockets. All of you are familiar with the Falcon rocket. So that is the initiative of SpaceX. And here I would like to tell you one more aspect. If someone talks about a Long March rocket, when you are looking at space program, rockets as well as satellites, these two are important. Satellites are launched into the orbit by rockets. And if you look at the name of the rockets, all of you are familiar with PSLV, GSLV, they belongs to India. Similarly, Long March rocket belongs to China. At the same time, Ariane space rocket belongs to European Space Agency, and the Falcon rocket belongs to this SpaceX Technologies of USA. These things, don't forget. Forbes magazine released the most powerful people. For fourth consecutive time, Russian President Vladimir Putin topped the list. Time magazine, number one rank has gone to Donald Trump. Forbes magazine, number one place has gone to Vladimir Putin, right? And as per Forbes magazine, Narendra Modi is at the 9th position. Look into the next one. Union Cabinet approved Major Ports Authorities Bill 2016. And two things I would like to tell you. India has got 12 major ports. They are under the Ministry of Shipping. Who is Minister for Shipping? Nitin Gadkari is the Minister for Shipping as well as Highways. That is one part. And the second part is, basically, the Union Cabinet cleared Major Ports Authorities Bill 2016, gives more powers to ports, right? So, India has got 12 major ports under the Ministry of Shipping, and I have listed out here, 6 ports towards West Coast, 6 ports towards East Coast, and out of 12, maximum 3 are situated in Tamil Nadu, don't forget. Tuticorin port, Chennai port, Kamarajar port, Ennore, right? So, these things don't forget. Look at the next one. Which country launched enhanced version of a Babur cruise missile? Here, Mughal Emperor Babur, all of you are familiar with. And this was launched by Pakistan and it is indigenously designed cruise missile. And it can carry all kinds of warheads up to 700 kilometers. Right? So, if someone talks about the Babur cruise missile, the country we are talking about is Pakistan. And bilateral aquamarine exercises were held recently at Kathu Lamu Atoll, and these are 7th joint exercises between India and Maldives. We discussed about certain aspects. A short while ago, we discussed about Pratikar. Pratikar are proposed joint exercises between Nepal and China. Konkan exercises between India and the UK. These things don't forget. Who among the following were named as International Tennis Federation Players of the Year for 2016? International Tennis Federation nominates or awards 2 persons, one men category, other one in women category every year. Andy Murray of Great Britain topped the list, or he was chosen as the Player of the Year in men's category, whereas Angelique Kerber of Germany got in women's category. As per the report published by United States of America's research firm, named the world's largest defense spender. United States of America is the largest defense spender with $622 billion. It is greater than the GDPs of several countries, and it is almost 1/3 of GDP of India, and India is at the 4th position, please don't forget, at $51 billion spending. The foundation stone for Indian Institute of Skills. This is going to be India's first skills development on the lines of premier institutions like IITs, IIMs. So, first ever Indian Institute of Skills is coming up at Kanpur. The Prime Minister laid the foundation stone for this. New Development Bank, people popularly call it as BRICS Bank, signed its first loan agreement for 525 million yuan for some solar energy project in Shanghai. And if you convert it into dollars, it equals around $76 million. Please don't forget these figures. Name the state where blockade of national highways disrupted supplies of fuels and food. The state we are talking about is northeastern state Manipur. And here the problem is the state reorganized the districts. Previously there were 9 districts. Now 16 districts are created. Basically, to meet the long pending demand of cookie majority district. There was long pending demand of cookies for a district. To meet their demand, districts were bifurcated from 9 to 16. And now the contention of Naga tribes or United Naga Council is their areas were bifurcated or divided. So Naga population felt that they were not consulted and the areas with Naga population have been divided. Right? Name the country which launched a CO2 monitoring satellite. Please don't forget, the name of the satellite is the TANSAT. And it was launched by, as I have already told you, Long March rocket. Long March rockets belongs to China, please don't forget. And Ariane rockets belongs to European Space Agency. And here I would like to tell you, this TANSAT is the satellite which monitors global carbon dioxide levels. Because all of you are familiar with global carbon dioxide levels, they came to 400 ppm. And this TANSAT satellite monitor every 16 days the carbon dioxide levels up to the accuracy of 4 ppm. So, if someone talks about quantum communication satellite, if someone talks about TANSAT, this all belongs to China, don't forget. And this was launched from their satellite launch center, which is located in Gobi Desert. And Gobi Desert spreads across two countries, China and Mongolia. And this is very important, National Institute of Securities Markets, or otherwise NISM, National Institute of Securities Markets, that is the educational initiative of Securities and Exchange Board of India, SEBI institution, National Institute of Securities Markets. This came up at Patal Ganga in Raigad district of Maharashtra. Recently, Prime Minister inaugurated it. So, if someone talks about National Institute of Securities Markets, this is around 80 kilometers from Mumbai in Raigad district at a place called Patal Ganga. So, it is basically the institution promoted by Securities and Exchange Board of India, the capital market regulator in our country. National Consumer Rights Day, we celebrate on 24th December. And this is the date on which Consumer Protection Act 1986 has received the assent of the President. And Jago Grahak Jago, this is basically the tagline. And this year theme is Alternate Consumer Dispute Redressal. And four consecutive days, please don't forget, December 22, National Mathematics Day, December 23, Farmers Day, that is birth anniversary of our former Prime Minister Charan Singh, December 24, Consumer Rights Day, December 25, Good Governance Day, that is the birthday of our former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. So, these things, don't forget. Look at the next one. Good Governance Day is being celebrated on 25th December every year. This is to mark the birthday of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. As I have already told you, National Farmers Day is 23rd, 24th is National Consumer Rights Day, 25th is Good Governance Day. The Prime Minister has laid the foundation stone for ₹3,600 crore Shivaji Memorial near Mumbai. And Shivaji is 17th century warrior king. And it is ₹3,600 crore memorial, and it created a lot of controversy because of its high cost involved. And its height will be 192 meters. I am considering combined height of both the statue as well as pedestal. If you look at the statues which have got greater heights in our country, Hanuman statue, situated near Vijayawada on Vijayawada Hyderabad highway, has got height of 41 meters. Then Tiruvalluvar statue in Tamil Nadu, then Tathagata, that is in Sikkim, that is having height of 39 meters. Then some of the tallest statues I have given, please go through them and look into the next one. Name the country where scientists identified hafnium carbide, HFC, and tantalum carbide, that is a TAC, as the world's most heat resistant materials. Heat resistance materials are very much required for supersonic vehicles. When the vehicle is a supersonic aircraft, results in high temperatures, and materials are required to withstand that high temperatures. Because of the friction involved while traveling at higher speeds, high temperatures are developed, and to withstand those high temperatures, this high heat resistant materials are required. And now the United Kingdom scientists stated that these two materials are world's most heat resistant, please don't forget, which can withstand temperatures up to 3700 and 3900 degrees centigrade, or you can say they melt at around 3700 and 3900 degrees centigrade. The name of the two materials is hafnium carbide and tantalum carbide. Please don't forget. India's first second generation ethanol biorefinery. This is coming up in Bathinda district of Punjab, and HPCL is constructing it. That is one part. Here, what is meant by this ethanol? Basically, this ethanol is used to blend with the petrol. Ethanol blending program is the flagship program of the government, and blending is allowed up to 10%. Please don't forget, blending in petrol by ethanol is allowed up to 10%. At present, average blending stands at 2.3%. So, government wants to give thrust for ethanol blending program. Then another important aspect, you may have a doubt, I used the word second generation. What is the difference between first generation and second generation? Here I used second generation ethanol biorefinery. What is the difference between first generation and second generation? First generation means the extraction of ethanol is very easy from sugars as well as vegetable oils. In second generation, the ethanol extraction is very much difficult because it involves extraction from biomass, that means woody crops as well as agricultural residue or waste. Then RBI opened 17th Ombudsman office in Dehradun. Last month, we learnt RBI opened 16th Ombudsman office in Delhi. Now, 17th came up at Dehradun. Easy Pay mobile application for merchants was launched by ICICI Bank. This application consolidates all digital wallets, QR code, UPI, credit and debit cards mode of payments. So, if someone talks about Easy Pay, this was launched by ICICI Bank. Prime Minister laid the foundation stone for Madan Mohan Malaviya Cancer Center in Varanasi. Please don't forget, Madan Mohan Malaviya is the brain behind Banaras Hindu University. And Prime Minister also inaugurated super speciality hospital in Banaras Hindu University. Now in the name of Madan Mohan Malaviya, this cancer center will come up in Varanasi. Prime Minister launched a National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme at Kanpur. Previously, we learnt about National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme. 3-4 points I would like to tell you. One is, this is monitored by Directorate General of Training under Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. That is one part. The main goal is to provide apprenticeship training to over 50 lakh youngsters. 50 lakh apprentices. Apprentices means they will be working in some industry, they will get skills enhancement. Basically, because of a skills enhancement, their job opportunities will increase. And the total outlay given by government is rupees 10,000 crore, and 50 lakh apprentices are to be trained by 2019-20. And here two things are very important. Central government will share 25% of the stipend paid. And second important aspect is, central government will also bear 50% of total expenditure incurred on providing basic training. National Mathematics Day was observed on 22nd December. I have already told you. Here, 2-3 important points I would like to tell you. The Man Who Knew Infinity, that is the film based on the life of Srinivasa Ramanujan. Srinivasa Ramanujan was born in Erode district of Tamil Nadu and died at the young age of 32 in 1920. And another important aspect is, the book The man who knew infinity, a life of the genius Ramanujan was written by Robert Kanigal, and the film was directed by Matthew Brown. So these things, and the actor in the film is Dev Patel. So these things, don't forget. Name the country which planned to levy environment tax to fight pollution from 1st January 2018. The country which is suffering badly because of pollution is China. So it is planning to levy environment tax to fight pollution from 1st January 2018. But carbon dioxide is not included, and it imposes a penalty for noise levels, air pollutants, water pollutants. And we have already discussed, TANSAT was launched to monitor global carbon dioxide levels. That is by China. Look into the next one. Name the country which tested new fighter jet, FC-31 Gar Falcon prototype. And this is basically competition to United States F-35 fighter jet. And United States F-35 is considered to be the world's most technically advanced fighter. And this one, FC-31 Gar Falcon prototype, was launched by China. Please look into this and please view this. This is US F-35. Aadhaar Pay, the country's first Aadhaar linked cashless merchant solution, was unveiled by IDFC Bank. This is very important. Government is trying to promote more and more Aadhaar linked transactions. And here, two points are very important. Remaining things, please go through this. Here, one important aspect is customer can pay by just bank name and Aadhaar number. Yes, Aadhaar number is interlinked with the bank account. We have to say only bank name and Aadhaar number. Subsequently, what is the password? Password is fingerprint. There is no PIN or any other thing. Here, very important aspect is customer can pay by just bank name and Aadhaar number, and the password is a fingerprint. It is going to become reality in future in our country. Then the last one, name the state where Mahabrindanatyam of Kuchipudi dancers created Guinness World Record with 6,117 performers. This Mahabrindanatyam was held in Vijayawada, part of capital region of Andhra Pradesh, and the performance lasted 13 minutes against the minimum requirement of 5 minutes, and it entered into Guinness Book of World Records with 6,117 performers. And please don't forget, Kuchipudi is a village in Krishna district of Andhra Pradesh, around 50 to 60 kilometers from Vijayawada. Right, friends, with this, let us conclude questions and answers for 52nd week. Have a nice day. Thank you.